All right, we all know that healthcare matters, and we now know there's more uncertainty in the system because of what just happened with this Republican bill going. So are there going to be price spikes, and is there a way forward? Let's get the bottom line with CNN senior political analyst Ron Brownstein. What is the bottom line on better days ahead for healthcare?
Look, this bill has been ground up. We've been watching it in real time. It's been ground up in the collision between GOP's historic ideology and its modern coalition. So on the one hand, you've got those voices on the right, Mike Lee, Rand Paul, saying it doesn't go far enough in uprooting Obamacare. And then you have a much larger group of moderates and even mainstream conservatives who say, look, we are taking away coverage primarily, largely from people who vote for us. I mean, you look at the numbers that the Urban Institute put together on who actually lost coverage under the Senate health care bill. 80% of them don't have a college degree. 70% of them are in a household where someone works full time. And about 60% of them are white. I mean, who does that describe? That describes the modern Trump coalition. There is no way around that conundrum for the Republicans.
So where does that leave them, Ron? I mean, what is next? We've heard MJ and everybody describe a repeal and delay strategy. We've heard that that's one option.
Right.
We've also heard, you know, the sort of dream scenario of let's get everybody in a big room and start over.
Well, look, if you're saying repeal and delay, that puts you in, I think, just a completely untenable situation. There's a reason they didn't do that in the first place. I mean, it denies coverage to 32 million people, and it reattaches the idea of taking away coverage from millions of working class, working Americans, because the coverage expansion is primarily on those who, you know, are working, and tying that to tax cuts for people at the top, as Chris was talking about. I mean, that is just politically toxic as can be. Look, I think what this requires you to do if you want to move forward is acknowledge something that's been really obscured in this debate. The problems with Obamacare are in the exchanges. I mean, it is with an adverse selection of the risk pool, not enough young people, too many older sick people. But the bills are centered on cutting Medicaid, which is a completely different, you know, system. It's centered on reducing Medicaid spending by $800 billion and knocking 15 million people off of the Medicaid program. That is a non-starter for Democrats. If you actually said we are going to focus on the problems in the exchanges, which are real, there is an opportunity, I think, for a different conversation. But the Medicaid cuts, I think, are simply kind of a deal breaker from the start.
So is the best chance for progress not this, this plenary proposition where what McCain was suggesting, that it comes back and we go through all the steps and everybody gets involved, but piecemeal? Maybe you take on prescription drugs. They're a big cost driver right now, then maybe you take on the different exchanges and you do bring in governors in those select markets, you know, and kind of create a hybrid where you help out on those exchanges. Do you think there's a chance for piecemeal the way there was some discussion about immigration being done instead of with an omnibus being done?
An interesting idea. Look, the core thing that has to be done is to stabilize the exchanges. The problem is that the critics of Obamacare don't really want to stabilize the exchanges. I mean, it's plausible to imagine if the Senate really hits a brick wall and they wanted to go in a different direction, you could find 50 plus one votes for something that would stabilize the exchanges. I don't think that would pass the House, though. I don't think House conservatives are looking to stabilize the exchanges. They want to repeal Obamacare. It is, again, this fundamental contradiction between the ideology of the party and the interests of its modern coalition. It's very hard to get around that at this moment.
Ron Brownstein, thank you very much for the bottom line on all of this. The piecemeal idea is what many suggested President Obama should do. I mean, I think Rahm Emanuel, when he was in the White House, was suggesting more of a piecemeal strategy rather than,
right,
you know, the whole kit and caboodle. That comes around again.
But you had opposition then from the GOP, wanted to get rid of all of it. They didn't want to do any fixing because they wanted it gone. Now you have that same dynamic flipped. Different names, same game. So the people who should matter most, you, right? And in polls, we saw that you didn't like this health care plan. You also don't like spiking premiums and deductibles you can't cover. So what will happen next?